What up, fools? You know what me and A&J Demolition both have in common? So we like to smash things. And I'll leave that to your imagination. Nah, but basically what they do is they rip apart old buildings and salvage the good shit from it and sell it to us as secondhand goods. Things like doors, windows, ranch lighters, and all that good shit. So don't be a fool and buy brand new shit when the stuff that they have is just as good. We both know that you don't have the money for that. So being the good cunt that I am, I've got your back. I've got a deal for you. So if you just call them up, say you listened on the Have a Look podcast, they'll hook it up, baby. Nah, yeah, but enjoy the show. So I let it lick the rap. G lick me like a lollipop. G lick me like a lollipop. What up, babe, mate?
Damn, bro, that was a good ad.
Oh. Did you like the intro music?
I like the ad more than the intro music, bro.
Mate, that took a solid 20 takes. Nah, fuck. But how's it going anyway, mate?
Good, brother. Good.
Big weekend of UFC?
Fucking huge, bro.
Saw your story, mate.
Fuck me, bro. See me, I reckon. Amanda Nunes, transfer me.
Bro, fucking hell. Fuck, I can't believe you tagged her, bro. She might come fucking looking,
bro. I get the reply. Me, you, brother, 1v1.
And then I'll reply, yeah, please. Nah. Well, how did you think about those fights anyway, mate?
Ooh. Nah, they're fucking mean, bro. Like, although she lost and it was shit for the bet, it was mean for the, like, a sport and for that, for both women's categories, because it was pretty out the gate.
Bro, I honestly thought that was one of my favorite cards, just because, like, bro, the prelims had fucking Bam Bam.
Yeah, fucking how about him? Bro. His knockout, G, it was like one of our fucking UFC 4 knockouts, bro. It was like when I have you up against the clinch and I break off, bang.
I know you don't want to taste Big Daddy, bro.
Oh, bro.
But fucking, he's a fucking character, bro. I reckon he's going to be that new fucking UFC star, bro.
Yeah, like, but the craziest thing was when he knocked him out, already had Steve, eh? Already sussed it.
Steve will
straight to the fence, bro. Straight up on the fence, got the beer, got the shoey. Everyone in the crowd.
Everyone's just shoes. Like, yeah. That was the craziest thing to me. It was like, everybody took off their shoes.
Bro, you could see lines things. Of people with their shoes. Those, like, ready to go.
Those fucking Americans, bro, they can't sing piss, can they? They, like, just throw it all on themselves.
Oh, out the gate. Bro, because him and Tyson Pedro, they have their own, you probably know it, their own beer. I can't even remember what it's called.
West.
Drink West. And I remember they were on what's his name? Brendan. Well, who's the below the belt fella?
Brendan Shaw.
They were on his podcast. And did you see when they got him to do the shoey?
Who? Brendan.
Yeah.
Nah.
Bro, because you know how when they do it, they spit in it.
Yeah.
Bro, Brendan spits in it. G smashes it. All right, that's what they reckon. The American shoeys no spit. Aussie shoeys spit. I was like, oh.
Bro, fuck. If you guys didn't have fucking toys, bro, I'd do a shoey right now, bro. Oh. We'll leave that for another day, bro.
Bobs won't do it.
Somebody hit me with a shoe, bro.
Oh, bro, no one's got a shoe for you, bro.
Yeah, exactly. But nah, yeah, that was...
But it has a knockout. Ugh.
That started off the bit well, bro. That was one of my... to be honest, bro, that was one of the safest ones.
Yeah.
I kind of knew that cunt was just going to throw, bro.
Yeah, definitely.
That cunt has got hands, bro. When you're from Western Sydney, bro.
He was the more, guaranteed out of the lot, I reckon. It was just a matter of time before he knocked him out.
Yeah, 100%.
Same with Sugars. He was fucking out the gate.
Sugar's got to be one of my favourite fighters at the moment, bro.
Yeah, true entertainer, brother.
I know he's fighting unranked dudes, but it's like, who gives a fuck, bro? Like,
even when just before he enters the octagon, eh? Hands out, looking around. Conor 2.0, bro.
Oh, he's like, and he's kind of riding that same wave as Conor, not as big, but he's like,
yeah,
that's what he's going for, right?
Yeah, there's definitely his blueprint, bro.
Bro, I don't get the cunt's celebration. Why does he always shoot?
Phoenix Suns, bro. That's his team. He's from Phoenix.
Yo, I know he's from Phoenix, but fuck.
That's his tribute to Phoenix, bro. Where he does the fadeaway.
Well, his tribute's not working because of their ass.
Who, Phoenix?
Suns suck, bro.
Oh, what?
Clippers the other day just wiped the floor with them, bro. Yeah. No Kawhi Leonard. No Patty Bev.
Let's not go off talking about that shit.
Sorry. I go all day about Patty Bev, bro. But no, nah, bro, Sugar. Oh, when do you reckon he'll get a ranked? I think
I just saw before the rankings got put out for bantamweight. He's 13 now.
So he's finally ranked.
Finally ranked 13. Bambam's still not, which is fucking out the gate.
Greg Hardy, apparently that Sakai fella was supposed to be pretty fucking top notch.
Yeah.
And then both first round knockouts. Yeah. Oh no, Bambam was second round out.
What, the fight just gone?
Yeah. I think he was second round, eh?
I didn't think so. Nah.
Was it first?
I'm pretty sure that was first.
Oh, fuck. Oh, I can't even remember.
Oh, actually, I might be wrong. But I think it was.
But nah, yeah, so, especially with the fucking slips, bro. That was like Bam Bam tick, Sugar tick. Mate, we're looking happy days.
Who do we have next? Who is my next one?
Oh, Kai Cutter.
Kai Cutter.
Bro, I could talk all day about this fella, bro.
Gate, bro. When he first dropped him. Holy shit.
What about his fucking...
What's up, bro? It was like a split second, eh? But they got that. They got the photo. fucking gangster. Bro, like, you see Izzy's one? You would have saw Izzy's...
Oh, his reaction to it, bro.
Bro, I reckon that was like every New Zealand lounge for that like, 2 minutes, eh? Like...
If somebody recorded us, bro, fuck me. I had
a fucking croaky voice after that, bro, because I was screaming.
Bro, we were all sitting down, beers in the hand. That first fucking knockdown, everyone dropped their shit,
yo,
bro.
Yo, dropped their shit and just bounced up.
Bro, everyone's in a huddle. We're like, oh, fuck.
That was crazy. And then, bro, pretty much, do you know what was the meanest thing about that? Like, he didn't, like, meathead rush in after that and try and finish him because he would have gassed himself out, like. And especially in a like massive fight like that, like it was fucking pretty on.
It was
like,
pretty mean of him.
He
to
was
like
so patient, bro. Like he just like sort of like waited, just started picking him apart, like, and then just landed.
Bro,
boom, boom, boom.
And like for the casuals out there, bro, Cody Garbrandt is like a fucking big name in the UFC.
Big
for Kai Cutter to get that, bro. He's even like talking about a potential title fight after this Brandon Moreno one.
Yeah. Bro, and another thing, you know, everyone keeps kind of like Cody Nolchin, like, bro.
As funny as it is.
As funny as it is, bro, that would have fucking KO'd anyone, bro. Like, everyone talking about, oh, poor Cody, like, oh, end of Cody Nolchin.
Yeah.
It's like, bro, give some fucking respect to Kai Cutter. Like, fuck, man. Like, those are some accurate and deadly shots he put on him, bro. Like, those weren't just no fluke shots. Like, it wasn't down to a glass chin,
bro. And I couldn't believe Cody was overlooking him, bro. Like,
yeah, called him Steve, eh?
Bro. Oh, it came off my Insta, bro. It was like, yeah, I'm fighting Stephen France.
Oh, my God.
Now, that's some fucking disrespectful shit, bro.
He's not calling him no Steve anymore, bro.
Now he's fucking daddy.
Yo.
No, yeah, but fuck, bro. What a day to be a New Zealander. Just fucking, you know, once we see like fellow Kiwis going hard, fuck, there's no better thing, eh?
Yeah, but do you know, I was watching Dana before breaking down the fights and that. He reckons someone in the crowd asked him, they're like, oh, who are you planning on giving Kai Cutter next? He said he's demanding a title shot. He's not fighting unless it's a title shot his next fight. And then I was like, He said that. Oh, well, we'll see.
Bro, I've seen some things, some like UFC pages. They reckon he should get that Askarov fight. Do you know that dude?
Yeah, where's he from?
I think he's Russian.
Russian or Polish or some shit.
He's something buzzy, bro.
I don't actually know too many flyweights apart from, you know, Figueroa and what's his name?
Figueroa, something like that.
And Moreno.
Yeah, well, Moreno. One of my favorite fighters.
He's the Moreno and Kai Cutter fought before, eh?
Yeah, and it was actually like close.
But this was ages ago. Yeah.
And that's kind of why I think Kai Cutter will be real confident going into that.
That'll be, bro. Imagine if Kai Cutter gets the champ, bro.
Fucking Izzy, Kai Cutter. They'll have to have a UFC event in New Zealand.
Yeah,
they will have to
get Volk on there.
Oh yeah, bro. Like,
that'll be crazy.
That because I know 138 said he'll shout us if the UFC event is coming to New Zealand.
Bro, but will he ever come after what he said?
After what? Oh, who? Izzy?
Remember Izzy said that he's not going to fight
he
in New Zealand?
He's never going to fight in NZ.
Yeah, but I think, I was just listening to what Kaikara did, his, what would it be, post-match interview, and he reckons he wants to fight for the flyweight title in New Zealand.
Yeah, yeah,
and
he said,
bring
well.
All the boys, blah, blah, blah. Like, I'm sure if that happens, like, he'll be able to, like, convince Izzy.
And I'm pretty sure that'll be, like, easy for Dana to do, to bring all the city kickboxing.
I think it's a lot easier said than done, like, just, it'll be, well, maybe with the new COVID restrictions opening and shit might be a bit easier. Systems.
Yeah, but fuck.
Because, hey, is it right? You don't have to isolate, now, when you come into the country. Is that right, Loss? If you're coming into the country, you don't have to isolate anymore, eh?
No, you have to for 7 days now, and then mid-Jan, you don't have to, if you're coming from Aussie and you're a New Zealander, you can do it at home.
So if they were to bring a UFC event, and say that there'd probably be American fighters and shit, they'd have to do a week ISO.
Yeah, if it was right now, yeah. But I'm pretty sure they've put out the, I can't remember the dates, but they've put out the, like, guideline of, like, when everything's going to change. Early next year, like April or something,
yeah.
People are going to be able to come in if they've got double vax and shit.
Oh, so yeah, because that's what put them off last
run. Imagine a Kaikara title fight and an Izzy title defence. In Auckland, bro.
Bro, and a Volk.
And a Volk.
Bring Volk and
fucking
Max.
Fucking triple
hitter,
bro.
Bring Volk and Max down here, bro.
Bro, was it when he said that he's gonna be paying for that, bro?
Who? He did say that, bro. He said if Izzy defends his title in New Zealand, he'll pay for it.
Who? Was?
Was said that.
Was.
If you're listening, Was, bro. We didn't forget what you said.
Come through with that one, Was. but let's talk about the fucking. The moment of the night, mate.
I didn't want to talk about it, bro. But,
The fucking, we were on the highest of highs.
Highest of fucking highs. So I'm like, what am I now? I'm 6 from 8.
You've only got Nunes.
6 from 8. I got Nunes and Charles Oliveira knockout or sub. So those two to knockout or sub.
And what were me and Nunn? We were on the same, mate.
We were on the same. And at that time, my pay, so... Let's run through my thing. I had Josh Emmett to win, Jeff Neal to win,
dub.
Sean O'Malley knockout,
dub.
Kaikara knockout,
dub. Fat dub.
So that's 4. Bam Bam knockout,
another dub.
So I got 5.
So you must have been 5 out of 7.
5 out of 7. Then I needed Nunes knockout or sub and Charles Oliveira knockout or sub. So the most So I got to Nunes and my cash out was 480, and I was like, whoa. Obviously not going to cash out here. Like, I'll Nunes, have a look after Nunes wins because it's pretty much guaranteed. But I was like, oh, I'll think about it like before the Charles Oliveira fight. So when, like, all the other fights, I was sweating like a fucking pig, like watching them because I was so nervous, bro. I was like checking my heart rate on my watch, checking it 110. I was like, fucking hell, especially in that Jeff Neal fight because Jesus, he did not make it easy.
Bro, yeah, that was decision, bro. We're all sitting down. They're like, oh, and the winner is Jeff Neal, babe.
Woo!
Jumps up,
screaming.
Fucking. The bro's celebrating like he's already won.
Yeah, because that's when we had a 480 cash out. And so my winnings was going to be $2,000.
Then
2,080 bucks or some shit. Get to the Nunes one. I was like, nah, it's not getting no way I'd cash out, bro. Like, 480 over $2,000, that's like pretty much fucking got one hand on it.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was like, nah, we'll just leave it. First round, Nunes getting fucking touched. Holy shit. Bear in mind, she's still landing shots.
Oh, no. I think first round, she looked good.
She like kicked dude, like leg kicked dude twice and she like dropped.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but the end of the first, she was getting touched. Yeah. And I was just like, whoa. It's kind of, but I was went into the second, like went to the end of the first. I was like, oh, not even worried, bro. Like, I was just like, you know.
Just a little fucking.
You're right, we'll be all right.
Yeah, it's a little brain fart.
Second round. Oh my fucking God, what was happening here?
Bro, I was the only one jumping up and down because I was in fucking disbelief. I was like, there is no way.
Tell you what,
this
bro,
is happening,
I was not
bro.
Jumping up and down, bro. My mouth was on the fucking ground, like, what is going on?
I remember looking at Beb and I was like, his fucking, he was just he's heartbroken, bro. He's like
heartbroken. So, yeah. So that happened. Juliana Pena was pretty out the gate. Like,
yeah, yeah. 100%.
Mad props. Like, it was pretty vicious. But, yeah. No, bro, when she started touching her up, you know how, like, whenever Nunes fights someone, you see it in their face and they're just like, what the fuck's going on? Bro, that's what Nunes was doing, Jay. You could see her. She was like, what the fuck?
And
like,
that's when we were all like, holy red, shit, red what's face, going on?
Eyes wide open, and she's just like, holy shit.
When has somebody ever whipped her like that, eh?
Bro, but I reckon she took, like, because DC keeps saying, like, now's the time to change levels, Like, and I reckon in the back of her mind, she was like, I should, but she was like, taking it personal that, like, this shouldn't be happening to me, bro. Like, she's punching me up, like, I should be doing to her.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She was kind of like, how dare this fucking chick.
So she's like, I'm not changing levels. I'm trying to fucking smash you. And then just ended up getting touched up, bro.
Yeah, that fucking backfired real quick.
Fucking backfired, all right? Fuck me, bro.
So even on that, bro, she's already... Juliana says she's going to give a rematch.
Yeah.
Are we doubling down on Nunes?
I'm going to see, bro.
This is the first time she's looked not indestructible.
You'd honestly say you'd be a fool not to, but fuck. You'd be a nervous fool. Damn.
Oh, I tell you what, bro. I think I might stay away from that one, bro.
Bro, honestly, that was the best or the closest I've ever been. So after this, so I lose.
Yeah. So that's bet done.
Bet done. Potential $2,000 done. Charles Oliveira, I'm like, well, now I'd feel less gutted if Poirier wins. Because, you know, then, like, I wouldn't be like, oh.
You wouldn't be, yeah, yeah. You'd be like, oh, I lost by two legs. Yeah.
And then Poirier also gets fucking touched up in the second round and choked out. And I'm like, holy shit, bro. Like, imagine if Nunes won. And we were watching fight, and that happened. Holy!
That's when the adrenaline's pumping. That's
when the adrenaline would have been pumping. But regardless of the bet,
Oliveira
was
bro.
Yeah, Oliveira was fucking mean.
Bro. I honestly don't see him losing. G.
He like, weathers the storm, eh? First round
takes
holy.
Some fucking damage, bro. But he even stated that after, like, to Joe. He was telling Joe, nobody can take damage like me and give it back.
Yeah. Well, that's like, what he did, bro.
Even in the Chandler fight, bro, got dropped first
round.
It's almost
like he, like, absorbs it and then fucking gives it back. He knows first round he's just weathering the storm, eh?
Oh.
You know what I reckon I saw? They were, like, did you notice they were, like, real close? Like, when they were standing?
Mm.
Like, they were just, like, almost toe-to-toe, like, most people, like, sort of stand a fair bit away from each other. But those dudes were just in each other's face, like...
Bro, the beauty of Oliveira, bro, was he was mixing everything up, bro. Yeah. Knees,
elbows. Even the types of elbows he was throwing was fucking mean. Like those jump elbows.
And then...
Jump elbows, switch knees.
I think Dustin kind of thought he was just going to throw kicks and throw hands. Like...
I think, bro, I said it before the fight to you, so everyone underestimates Charles Oliveira on his feet,
eh? Yeah.
Like... They just think, oh, BJJ black belt, like most submissions in UFC history, like that's all he does. Bro, he's actually deadly on the feet, bro. Yeah.
Just a fucking beautiful fighter, bro.
Yeah, like, he is, all round.
Joe said it perfectly, bro. He's like, those knees to the body, they're hurting him.
Oh, big time. But, because you know how, when did we, also, was it end of round one when he, no. When did he finish him? Round three. Oh, yeah, how can we forget?
Yeah.
No, bro. So round two, on him hit him and mount the whole time.
Elbows.
Heavy elbows, bro.
Yeah, if you're going to give Dustin... Like,
and the fucked up thing, how did they not open him up, bro?
That's what I was going to say, like, he's a fucking tough cunt.
Bro, I thought, because he kept turning his head, I thought he was going to pop his cauliflower, Jay.
Oh, because
he kept landing it straight on. I was like, oh, this is going to fucking burst.
Hey, and do you know, did I tell you, I had like a little side bet on him second round, eh?
Fucking dog.
On Oliveira's second round. So in my head, I'm not celebrating. I'm like, yo, he's going to fucking kill him, bro.
What did you have on it?
I had $25 on him to just finish him.
Foolish, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Should have listened to Knackers, bro.
Oh, I just seen it, bro, and I was just like, yo, Dustin can't keep up with this, bro. Like,
yeah, how's about Narns on, eh? Like,
yeah. Oh.
Fucking perfectly played out. He went, what do you go, round three finish. Didn't pick the finish, eh?
Nah, yeah,
he just goes round three finish, yeah, Oliveira. And, bro, by the time round two finished,
it was almost like inevitable.
Like, looking at Poirier, I was like, oh, he's actually not that fucked. Like, because he looked all good.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
He was, bro. When you went into round three, he was just like.
That second round played out so perfect for Knackers. Yeah. Dude. Like, yeah. Just ground and pound, beat him up, wear him down. Ready for taking in round three.
Round three on his back.
Fucking tin ass cunt Knackers, bro. That was his first big win, too. So, you could imagine that.
Yeah. 600.
Oh.
600 for Knackers.
Yeah, bro. Fuck, that's cracking. But, fuck, honestly, yeah. One of my favorite cards so far, bro. Just like the upset. As much as I hated my bet losing, fuck, that's got to feel good for Juliana, bro.
Yeah.
So, that was probably one of the main reasons. Kai Cutter, fuck.
See,
absolute beast.
Dana reckons that. Well, because you know he's been in talks with Kayla Harrison?
Nunes.
No, Dana has been in talks with Kayla Harrison.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He reckons, because someone was asking, is that the fight to make, Kayla Harrison Nunes? He was like, well, it was, Nunes won. He was like, but now I've got to rethink it. But he's like, we're still in talks. Yeah, we're definitely talking. But like.
Fuck, she's a beast.
Yeah, but she's too big, isn't she?
Yeah, she's 155.
What's Nunes?
I think they're fighting at 35.
What's that? Yeah, Jamie. No, 135.
Loss. What's 135 in kgs? Oh, it's bantamweight men's. So what's like Piotr Jan and shit? 60. Know, maybe 60.
Nah, that's.
Come on, Loss. I thought you're that quick math, bro.
Is this the wish, Jamie?
Yeah, sorry, guys. We're looking to upgrade Jamie.
61 kgs.
So that's what they fought. And what's Kayla Harrison?
155. So so she's like Connor. Like Connor, Dustin, like that.
Oh, so she's big.
She's big, G. Like,
oh, yeah.
Oh, she'd have so to cut reckon, some weight.
Do you reckon that'd open up another weight category?
They couldn't do 155. There wouldn't be enough people.
Well, would they make a drop?
One, like, surely she just drops to 145 and Amanda goes up to one. That's kind of like meeting in the middle, you know?
Well, there's not even a 145, is there? What's bantamweight?
Fuck, there is no one.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, are they have to? Surely they just open one up because like it's a bit rough, bro.
Surely
like,
they
bringing
just go
her in and making her drop.
Surely they just go catch weight, bro. Like, if you guys meet at 145, it's we're all good to go.
Just not even for the title.
Oh, because I just think
Rumble.
Yeah, I just think Kayla Harrison is a. Beast,
right? Yeah, she is.
Is she 2-time Olympian?
2-time Olympian
judo.
Gold medalist. Bro. Judo brother.
Okay.
Judo brother. Father was here. Judo brother. Best ever. That's next level, brother.
That's one of my favorite like talks. Hey?
Yeah,
like,
that's me now.
Those people sitting around the table. Let's just talk about some potential fights, bro, because the one that I'm looking forward to the most is Colby versus Kumshat.
Now that's disrespectful. Who's
Hamza Chimaev?
Oh, yeah.
But you know Colby Rowe. He's the funniest character going around at the moment.
Yeah.
Isn't his name Kumshat?
He's pretty.
He's fucking had me dying, bro.
Yeah. But bro, Hamza is a different beast, bro. Pull that mic in, bro. That's the second time I've had to do that.
My fucking
chopping up,
mate, because I can hear well.
But that's the third time I've had to do that. Full
chopping up, bro.
I'm sorry, you guys are deaf, but I can hear quite well. That's why it's like
I'm not pulling it in for the volume, bro. It's because the camera keeps unfocusing on your face and focusing on the mic.
It's probably not a bad thing, bro.
Fuck me, there missing out on the gold. I think Loss just comes over here to fucking get his face in the action.
No, but. Hums up, bro. Well, what was that stat about his last three fights? He's absorbed one strike shit.
One strike.
In three fights.
Yeah. But who was he for, bro?
doesn't matter, bro. The UFC fighters, like, that's unreal.
Surely Sugar would be on that same kind of...
No, what?
Who's touched Sugar, bro?
What do you mean? In his last three fights.
Okay, not one, but...
In one of his last three, you're knocked out.
Sugar? Oh, Marlon. Nah, that doesn't count, knocked bro. Out.
That's, well, you got...
That's why Sugar does this, bro. Oh,
that's the funniest
That part. Is why he does that.
Yeah. 13-1.
Yeah.
That's correct.
Oh, yeah, he doesn't, like, acknowledge it.
Doesn't acknowledge it, yeah.
But anyways, Colby is fucking... Oh, he's killing Hamza, bro. Yeah. I'll respect him and say Hamza because I wouldn't want to see him out on the street.
Yeah, bro. You're like all those dudes on the keyboard. Gunshot. Then you see him in person. Oh, you're so good, bro.
Hamza. Nah, but if I had Colby as my security, bro, I'm saying, come shot.
Fucking fool, bro.
Because what's next for Colby, bro? 2 hours to Kamaru.
Jorge, bro.
He's killing Jorge.
What do you mean? Well, they're both... He's come off a loss and so is Jorge.
Jorge's... Oh, yeah.
That's what
Jorge,
I mean.
But Jorge's coming off a fucking devastating knockout, bro. He needs to fight Leon Edwards, bro.
Well, you could argue Leon. He's come off wins.
Yeah.
Bro, Jorge Colby is the fight to make, bro.
Oh, it's just... Jorge's... Oh, that's a hard one, bro. Stand up. You know Colby's just going to...
Wrestle him.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
100%.
But Jorge's... D's, Wrestle D is pretty mean. Welcome.
That would be a great fight because of their history. Eh?
Yeah, big like, time. They used to be mates.
Yeah, used like, to be best mates. Yeah. Bro. Like, they used to live together.
Well, I didn't know that, Jake. Yeah. I seen photos like of them like training together and then like, yeah, like actually used to like flat together and stuff. Yeah,
It was either like Jorge let him sleep on his couch or the other way around or something like
what,
that.
What actually happened? Do you know?
Oh, bro, you know the fucking media. There's just so many, like, people's got so many different stories about it.
There's no, like, proper story. Like, yeah.
Jorge or Colby both say different things. So you're just like, shit, yeah. What the fuck is there to believe?
Yeah. It's out of it. Do you ever wonder if it was, like, a planned thing?
Like, they planned
like they sort like behind all the media and that, they actually like each other? Like, they're still good mates?
Fuck, I don't know, eh? Because it's well known that Colby's, like, actually a really good dude.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Apart from his persona.
And, like, it's just, like, mean for, like, the hype of, like...
Yeah, yeah.
The whole UFC and that.
Fuck. Oh, you never know, eh?
Like, imagine if they're still good mates and they're just, like...
Just finessing everyone.
That
shit,
like,
yeah,
tease
yeah.
each other. Oh, do that. Say that, bro. Yeah.
Same with fuck with, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, that... Fuck, if they...
Journeyman, Masvidal.
Yeah. What does he call him? Street Judas.
Street Judas.
Yeah, Street Judas, bro. That's critical. See, nah, I'm so keen to fucking... If they tee that up, bro, that's a...
Yeah, that's a fight to make, bro.
Oh, and because Jorge pulled out of this Leon fight,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah. See?
Fuck, would you almost...
When is that?
Would you almost chuck Colby in that?
Colby Leon.
Yeah. I mean, who else does he have to fight?
No, who are they giving him? Have they not got anyone for Leon yet?
Oh, did they give him somebody?
I don't know. Maybe not.
Oh, I think they're just talking about it, eh?
Yeah, not sure.
Okay, bro, what about... What do they do with Connor, bro? He's called out...
Wait, did you say... Did you say him? So when are me and Charles fighting next?
Yeah, bro, he's
bro,
gonna
he's
be
crack up, bro.
Knows how to stay in everyone's mind.
Yeah,
today.
Stay. Yeah, and bro, you know, I would not be surprised if he gets it. It's fuck. Conor McGregor, bro.
It's Conor McGregor, bro. That'll
even though he's what's he ranked? 8th. He's ranked 8th.
Is he not even top 5?
Nah, why would he be top 5?
Fuck, he's been fighting people like he got Dustin twice, and Dustin was like 2.
Nah, he's 9. Pretty sure he's 9. Hey, Jamie.
Yeah, tell us what the rankings are, mate.
No, but I think he's not. But Ally Quinter, he got Habib when he was 11.
But wasn't that because there was like constant pullouts and everybody else had fights?
Yeah, but still, an 11th ranked fighter got a title shot.
Khabib, what a
rat.
Don't even start, bro.
He's a fake humble dude. He was humble in the ring, and now he's just like dissing everyone.
How's he fake humble?
He's dissing everyone now. He used to be like, no, always good, always good.
He still is.
Bro, anytime there's a fight, he puts his, he's just like, oh, he's not as good as me, blah, blah, blah.
You're like, bro, he does.
You ask anyone.
Oh, I haven't seen that, bro.
Because you're not on Twitter, bro. Get on Twitter.
As
on
of Twitter, the bro. 19th of July, he was number 9.
There we go, 9. I said that.
19th of July.
I fucking do my research, bro.
Yeah, you might have done your research on the 19th of July.
Well, I'm pretty sure it hasn't been changed since then.
Yeah, because he's fucking just taking it out.
That's the last update.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Thanks, James.
So, I reckon... Bro, okay, yeah. Fucking give him Charles, bro. Feed him to Charles.
Oh, that's not a good matchup, bro. That is not a good matchup.
Yeah, because everyone knows Conor will be searching for that round one knockout, bro. Yeah. And that's not coming, bro. He knows how to weather that storm, bro. He's done it twice in the last two fights now.
But I honestly reckon if anybody could, I think Conor, like, he would be the dude to do it. If he could get a first round
out, knockout, what? Out of who?
Gaethje, Chandler.
What about Habib?
Fuck. Habib was not beating Charles, bro.
Bro, I reckon he's the one dude that could beat him.
Yeah.
See, bro.
Habib would
Charles don't want that, waters,
bro. That's kind of a fight that I want. Who is he for actually good on the ground?
Tony?
They didn't fight.
Yes. He nearly snapped his arm.
No. Khabib.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Charles.
No. That's what I mean. Like a Khabib Oliveira one where he's fighting a fucking absolute freak on the ground.
Michael Johnson? Wrestler?
He's not fucking...
Slapped him and told him to give up?
Most submissions ever.
Yeah, well, you're not going to find that. You're only going to find that person once, aren't you?
That's what I mean. Feed him Khabib, bro. Khabib's not old. He's like... Staying fit?
Nah, he's not finding it, bro. I'm about legacy, brother. No money. Legacy.
That's cap, bro.
What do you mean that's cap?
That's cap.
Hell.
No, he's just... I'm a Khabib hater, bro.
Yeah, like, I don't... Bro, I'm not a anyone hater, bro.
I'm a Khabib hater, bro.
I just respect Khabib's greatness, bro.
You call him the GOAT, though. That's like... That's so... Please. That's more than a like your Khabib on his nuts.
On inside the ring and outside the ring, he's more successful and how do I say it, bro?
Boring.
Looked
boring. that's the word.
No, he's more appreciated, respected.
Well,
then
I'm sure anyone can do that if you don't.
Bonnie Jones, bro.
Okay, my man's a bad man outside of the octagon.
Yeah, where do we start, bro? You cannot call someone the greatest of all time, like...
If they've had outside...
Yeah.
Okay. On that. Is Tiger Woods the greatest golfer of all time?
Well, I don't know much about golf, bro. That's not my area. So I don't really
You
know.
Want to say yes.
No, because, well, I only know, like, him and Phil Mickelson, and I don't really know me.
Okay, what about...
Rory McIlroy.
What about...
Bulls, I'm not even going to give you the luxury of changing the camera and doing it for you. Pull your fucking mic in, bro.
Is that not in?
You keep pushing it out, bro.
I don't like things shaped like that
near
my
mouth. See, look at Bibbs.
Beb likes those kind of things near his mouth. You just fucking
unless you want your face to look fuzzy the whole time.
He'd want it closer if he could.
No, that's my bad.
But I just think inside the octagon, mate, he's the GOAT.
Yeah, but like in the scheme
of things,
he's not.
Okay, if you have
overall, he's not.
If you have to take into account his.
Take into account that he hit a pregnant lady with her kid in the car, tried to flee the scene, and then ran back to his car with the lady next to it because he forgot his bowl of weed, and then grabbed the bowl of weed, looked at the lady, and then ran off.
Okay, I don't.
Is that what would LeBron James do that, bro? Would Michael Jordan do that,
bro? I'm pretty sure it's not. Oh no, actually, LeBron's a fucking.
Bro, LeBron is squeaky clean, bro.
Yeah, yeah. I wasn't gonna say that. I was gonna say something about MJ, but it's not as bad as what Bones done, bro.
Well, what did he do? Bet a few thousand on something. That's all he's done, bro.
Bro, you hear rumors that he's like bet almost his life away, bro. That's why they like,
bro. You know what do you mean, bro? How you know how much that man's worth? He's not betting his life away.
Oh, apparently it was bad, bro. Like. Oh, but then again, Scotty like says some out of it shit, bro.
Who's Scotty?
Scotty Pippen.
Oh,
he's like a big MJ hater now.
But if you can afford to bet it, I reckon you can bet it, Jay.
Yeah, fully, bro. Especially like him, fucking hell, multi-billionaire.
Oh, but he wasn't at the time.
Oh, right.
Yeah, we're talking about like when he had to go to baseball.
Yeah,
there was so many like.
Well, they talk about that on that Last Dance.
Yeah, that.
As for your fool Johnny Bones, bro.
Oh, he's fucking.
I bet you his brothers shake their head at him, bro.
Okay. Fighting wise, is he the GOAT? 100%. You can't even, like, fake that.
Well.
And then he's going to beat Ngannou for the fucking heavyweight championship.
Oh, my God.
Okay, ready? If he gets.
Bro, Cyril Garn's beaten him before Ngannou, bro.
Beating who?
Johnny Bones. Fuck. I'd say Cyril Garn would beat him more convincingly than Johnny Bones.
Jamie,
do then Ngannou.
Jamie, can you swap with Bear Bro now, please, mate? He's fucking talking some rubbish, bro. Cyril Garn is a fucking...
A calculated fighter?
He's a wish version of John Jones.
Oh my God.
If any of you guys know proper UFC, holler at me. I need a new.
Bro, leave that fucking mic, bro. You want to get told off again? I'm going to have a spanking loss. Fucking hell, bro.
Well, stop fucking winking at me.
You're like an amateur over here, bro.
Oh my God. Are you drunk, bro? Fucking two beers deep drunk.
What else you got for me, bro?
Oh.
What other bullshit topics you got?
Oh. Bam Bam's next opponent, mate.
Bam Bam's next opponent.
Surely. Because Bam Bam's not even ranked, eh?
Bro, do you know what? No, off, not to the Bam, but bro, they got to give my dog Tyson a fight, bro. Tyson they do, Pedro, bro. And bro, because he was meant to have one October. But COVID and shit fucked it around. But like, give him a fight, man. Damn.
Bro, he beat OSPA.
I can't remember. He's definitely fought him.
The fuck, did he?
Bro, he fought Latifi, bro.
Oh, I know, which is fucking... Yeah. Honestly, bro.
Reckons he's the strongest dude that he ever fought.
Fuck, he's a big man.
Little Latifi, nugget egg.
Bro.
Yeah.
So who does he train? Who does?
I don't know, bro.
Is he with Bam? It must be.
Yeah, yeah.
They're like best mates or something.
Yeah.
Bro, fucking give Tyson a fight, bro.
Yeah, bro.
What is he, light heavyweight?
Yeah, light heavyweight.
Oof.
Big dog, bro.
That is a fucking big man.
Bro. Yeah.
But if he fights Johnny.
He's not fighting Johnny yet, bro.
Yeah, but. Let's say he eventually does. I'm going to have to sit on the fence, mate.
My dog Tyson for the knockout, bro.
The heart saying Pedro, but, you know, I can't. I can't get past Johnny, bro. Because, no, he... ACL? Pedro.
No, I don't know.
He had a mean injury, bro. That's why he had to pull out.
Oh, I can't remember. Probably.
Yeah, I think it might have been ACL because I used to follow him for a bit, eh?
Oh, yeah.
And then, yeah, just fucking.
Because that thing we did was fucking crack up, bro.
Oh, yeah. Maybe we even, like, show a snippet of it, bro. Show a bit. Looking like fucking. Oh, I couldn't even explain.
Looking like fucking
you.
Captain Cook, bro. Fuck me.
I don't know how you got that gig.
That was funny, bro.
Fuck, we even.
Did you see that loss, bro? What? My acting career.
Yeah.
I was in the music video for damn, what's her name?
You don't even know her name, mate.
What's her name? Fuck, oh, I forgot.
So about 10 seconds of your mug.
Yeah, yeah.
I was sitting there. I was like, Mike Wazowski. I'm on TV. Don't even see me. It's in the background, blurred out.
Oh, would you have felt disrespected if they like went past you? Oi,
what's her name, bro? Bathing in the River. I hope she doesn't listen to this, bro.
Well, if you are, Bibs disrespected the fuck out of me.
Who sings Bathe in the River? Lost?
Jamie, get it up, bro.
Hurry up, Jamie. Fucking hell.
Bathe in the River. Oh, you want to hear me sing that after a few minutes?
Getting underpaid for this bullshit, bro.
Bro, go Siri, who sings Bathe in the River? Fuck, who is it?
Holly.
Hey, Siri, Holly Smith.
Holly Smith.
Holly Smith.
Yes, bro.
So it was for Holly Smith's music video.
Yo, because that's a fucking
And then what they reckon...
Featuring Holly Smith.
Holly Smith, yeah. They reckon they wanted two MMA fighters, so they got me and Tyson.
Holy... Jay, so you weren't here.
So Tyson was...
You weren't here. So when I had Dumb and Dumber on, Caleb and Knackers, I told them about how I tapped you out at jiu-jitsu twice.
Can we just clarify that's never happened?
That's cap.
Are you kidding?
That's cap.
How? How did it happen?
We're going to have to hold an event.
No, how did it happen?
Well, I got you in an armbar.
Talk shit, bro. Just admit.
Anyway I want, I'm tapping this dude out 9 times out of 10.
Oh, my God.
We're going to host later on in the track, we're going to host a 138 event. 138 employees. Fight night.
Fight night? Damn, what? We're putting gloves on.
But then if I have gloves on, then I can't submit people. UFC gloves. We'll go UFC gloves.
I don't know if you want that, bro.
Fuck, I want all the smoke, bro. Give me meathead. I think meathead's getting tapped out first round. With loss. We'll let the girls chill. You just don't have to come in, bro. We'll let the girls chill. Unless we bring a girl in for you, bro. But that's about it. But no, yeah. Oh, actually, that's what I was going to ask. Jake Paul, mate. Jake Paul, Tyron Woodley, Monday.
Is it Monday?
Yeah. Who have you got, bro? Who are we?
I don't like that, bro. Like, it's just too, like, political and scripted and I don't know.
So you believe Dylan Dennis that he got paid to...
Is that drop? What Dylan Dennis reckons?
Dylan Dennis, the funniest dude, by the way. He reckons he's got inside knowledge that Tyron Woodley was paid off.
Oh, bro, 100% I believe that. 100%. And I reckon something dumb like that's going to happen this fight.
Again?
Yeah.
I just...
You cannot tell me, bro, that...
Jake Paul.
Even watching that fight, Tyron Woodley just, like, pretty much stood there and just, like... He, like, stunned him once, but, like...
Yeah, even when he stunned me, that's
didn't
not...
Didn't do anything.
If you've seen T-Wood in the UFC, you know when he stuns somebody, he's all out.
Reckless abandonment.
He's dropping the game plan, and he's looking for that finish. That's kind of why
that's
we
why
were
it was
like...
That's why it was like, oh, bro.
We're like, fuck.
It's just too...
Definitely looks staged.
Yeah.
We're like, fucking hell, fool. Go and fucking knock that cunt out.
That's why I wanted Tommy to fight him, because I reckon...
Tommy wouldn't buy into that shit, eh? Like...
Well, I don't know, you'd think T-Wood wouldn't either, but like...
I could see why T-Wood...
Need that moolah, bro.
Yeah. I heard...
Tommy's got that, bro, he doesn't need it.
I heard Uncle Dana isn't a paying fighter as well. So
Mike Perry, hey.
Oh, Mike Perry's getting paid heaps, bro.
Didn't he give him mil? Something like that? Or was that bullshit? It is...
That might be true, but I don't even know what he's fighting at now. That's like...
How, yeah, like what's the competition he's in?
I couldn't even
something random.
You.
Is it boxing? It's boxing though. It's not MMA.
So what? He just boxes now.
Yeah, and he got paid fucking heaps, and like more than he's ever been in the UFC. Like all his fights combined from his one fight.
Uncle Dana, I know you're listening to this.
Dana Stinge, bro.
Pay the fucking fighters, mate. They're out the gate.
I don't know you're listening to this. I know Dana doesn't want to listen to you, bro.
Fuck, he'd be a smart man. He did. Oh, how are we for time, mate? How are we for time? What's the time?
3:50.
Fuck, we've been chatting shit for that long. 4 minutes, bro. Oh, fuck me. Well,
wrap this up, bro.
Yeah. Thank you for joining in. Probably post another one next week. Maybe have Beb. Hopefully, Timur, if you're watching, we'd love to have you on, bro.
Timur or Coxie, bro. That's
yeah, Coxie. Fuck. Even if you want to talk about how bad your fantasy team went, mate, we'll have you on for that as well. So we'll catch you next time, guys. Cheers. Thanks, Beb.